Last time we were reciting the great verses from Sahasranam, which are all precious instructions for improving the quality of our daily living. The root stu occurred in many of the names. Stu means to praise. And I tried to interpret all the names practically by pointing out it is good to sing the praise of the Lord in kirtans and bhajans, in hymns and songs. But it is also necessary to praise the Lord in our action, in our behavior towards everyone around us. In other words, it's not enough if we keep on singing bhajans, if you are unkind to people. It's not enough if we keep on singing hymns in the most glorious voice possible, to the accompaniment of the rarest organ in the world. It is equally necessary to be patient with everyone around, to be kind to everyone around, to work harmoniously with people, to be able to turn back upon our petty personal prepossessions and prejudices to contribute to the growth of all around us. Similarly, you'll find the word vasi occurring many times in the verse I'm going to comment upon this evening. Vasi means to dwell, and in this sense, Vasudeva, Vasudeva. We'll come to the name, can always apply to every human being, to every creature, as they in whom the Lord of Love dwells always. And the sole purpose of life is to evolve to that higher stage in which we are able to transform all negative emotions into positive, all lust and anger and fear into devotion to the Lord who is present in everyone, every minute. I've been asked to comment upon how to deepen devotion to the Lord of Love, whether we call him Krishna or the Christ, and the answer is very simple. To practice patience, forbearance, forgiveness, goodwill, friendship, love to everyone. That is how devotion is developed, and it is necessary for deepening devotion to be with people for the purpose of idle gossip, but it is in the give and take of everyday life that we are able to rub off the angles and corners of our personality, to smoothen the edges that often give pain to others. So we have in our ashram, among our friends who are devoted to the spiritual life, a great opportunity for deepening devotion. And any time you are insensitive to the needs of those around, you forget the needs of those around by getting caught in your personal pleasure, you are doing the opposite of deepening your devotion.